Hi, this is Wing Commander Santosh Sharma. I am the founder of White Water Spirituality. In this video, we'll be talking about a question which normally people ask: which stone is most powerful? I'm talking about the gemstones. Which gemstone is most powerful from the astrological point of view? You see, if you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, because I keep making videos relating to the astrology, gemstones, and Rudraksha. Now let's come to this question. If somebody asks, which is the most powerful food on this planet? What will be your answer? It will depend. For what purpose you want the food to work in your system? Do you want protein? Do you want carbohydrate? Do you want the other things from the food which is useful by the body? You want to make your mind alert, or you want to make your physically strong? Depends as per your need. Second thing, in astrology, gemstones are used to boost the energies which are dormant, in the sense that they are vakri, they are less powerful, they are retrograde. Gemstones are used to give a fillip to the boost, a push to that particular energy. For example, if the Jupiter, Brihaspati, is not good in the chart, then a yellow sapphire, a pukhara, is given to you to boost the power of Brihaspati or the Jupiter. Similarly, if the Shani or the Saturn in your chart is good for you, but it is vakri, so less powerful, then also a blue sapphire, the nilam, is given to you to boost the energy. So it will be decided which stone is powerful for you depending on the graha of your chart, the status of the graha, the dasha, mahadasha. Supposing I tell you another thing, you are undergoing Shani Mahadasha, Saturn Mahadasha. Time of Shani is running now and Saturn is not good for you. Would you like to boost the energy of Saturn if it is not good for you? No, that is not the time to wear a stone to boost the energy of the Saturn, because Saturn is not good in the chart. For that you have to wear a 17 Mukhi Rudraksha. So you have to use your discretion when to use a stone, when not to use a stone. For example, you are undergoing Shani Mahadasha. That time if you try to boost the power of Surya by wearing a ruby, then it will be counterproductive. So first of all, you have to understand which energy you want to boost. Second, what the dasha mahadasha is undergoing. Third thing is that what that you want from this particular stone. What is your need? What the aim? What the purpose of wearing a stone? That's what is very, very clear. Otherwise, it is not going to help you. So the asking a question like that, which gemstone is the most powerful one, is a generalized question, and the answer which will be given to you also a generalized form. My advice to you will be that have a discerning mind, apply your mind, understand why you want to wear a particular stone, for which energy, which planetary energy you want to use that stone, then only use a stone. In the next video I will be talking about another question: which are the gemstones you can club together to wear? Like, you know, if you have not watched my video on the Navagraha, nine gemstones, you know, people wear together. I am totally against it, because you should not to boost the power of the energy which is not good for you, right? So I am against wearing these nine forms of stones together, but there can be some exceptions, and I would like to highlight basically which are the gemstones you should not wear together in the next video. If you are not subscribed to the channel, do subscribe and share with others. Namaskar.